The really special thing about Valiance is that not very often does the page and the expectations and the physical get together and really tell the story and fulfill the prophecy.
She's a beautiful, beautiful filly. I can still remember when she came to Saratoga as a yearling, that she came out of the stall there at Blue Water. Big, gray, beautiful, beautiful yearling.
You know, there's not very many times in my life where I have had a yearling that she was out of a grade one winner who was out of a grade one winner. You know, those expectations are strong. And being by Tappet, she really was meant to be the star of our show. She took on everything she was supposed to do. Every time you asked her a new question, you know, she went forward, took the step forward, but she did ask you first if you're sure you meant it. That kind of part of her personality, I think, served her well.
Well, Valiant's a filly that always showed a lot of talent from early on, and you know, for her to win her debut, first time out going long on the turf, that's a difficult task. As she matured, she got better and better on the dirt. That's what convinced us to give her a try in the race at Monmouth. You have to watch that race to appreciate how easily she won that day. I mean, she was literally hardly ridden at all.
Valiance on the outside. Absolute sheer confidence from Nick Juarez as Valiance now breezes to the front. Gotham Gela is back to second, but Valiance is too classy, and she strides out beautifully to win the Eatontown.
You know, her real breakthrough performance was when she was able to win the Grade 1 Spinster at Keeneland and beat a quality field that day.
And they're off in the Judmont Spinster.
And to win a Grade 1, especially at a prestigious track like Keeneland, that was a great win.
Valiance with the advantage. Ollie's Candy runs on at her from the outside. She dares. The devil is there toward the inside. Ollie's Candy running out of time. Valiance with the lead. Ollie's Candy trying. Valiance prevails by 3/4.
When it all comes together like that, it's magic. There's nothing like that in racing. I mean, that's just that moment when the heart and the pedigree and they lay it on the line, leave it on the track. That's all you're looking for.
Her Spinster performance last year was outstanding, but also the effort that she put in the Breeders' Cup followed that up. I mean, she paired those races, you know, back to back with really, really meaningful performances. And then as an added extra or an added bonus, you know, you get the ability to, you know, she's a stakes winner on the turf. So you say, how, you know, whatever we want to do with a filly like Valiance or a mare like Valiance in the breeding shed, we've got every opportunity in front of us.
Well, I think the one great thing about Valiance is she was ultra consistent. She showed up and ran well every race. I think she had that combination of speed and the ability to carry it over a route of ground, and she was very competitive. I think anytime you take a mare with her conformation, her pedigree, and her racetrack ability on multiple surfaces gives you a horse that you would think would be a slam dunk as a broodmare prospect.
You take pride when you sell quality horses at a yearling sale that go on to achieve success. It's a good group that owns her, and it's an honor to have an opportunity to sell a filly of this quality.
It's all right here on the page. You know, she's out of a grade one winner who's out of a grade one winner. You really can't get any better than this. I mean, elegance, beauty, balance, bone, all those things put together. And she's by Tappet. She's a collector's item. She's a unicorn.